It's always a pleasure to see you sauntering over.
I've had better days and worse ones. Take that. It says there's a cellar here somewhere.
I don't see one.
And you got nothing to show for it.
What's that? To rest.
Can't give up now. Stay idle.
Soldier.
Recognize the tiny fiend, a quozzet. Wicked creatures often used as familiars.
Wait! You smell funny. Like fire and iron. Like a dragon. Tells you a secret. A big secret. Like this. Dragon Shovel is gonna eat your babies! Tell Mira. Balsam good. For wounds. Thank you. balsam good for wounds.
Still breathing, despite everything.
Speak your name. I do not know this name. If you are known to my master, step forward and declare yourself an ally. Master was human, pure and true. You are not Illyntoth. If you are his ally, step forward and declare it.
There is a pause as those glass eyes take you in. Then...
What's the story?
See? Tell you truth, Beefy! Trust me. Always. Always! See? Tell you truth, Beefy! Trust me. Always.
Is that blood? No, never mind.
Go on, talk to Mira. Balsam good for wounds. Go on, talk.
Let's march.
See? Tell you.
No one stopped me yet.
recognize the tiny fiend, a quozzet. Wicked creatures often used as familiars.
Wait, you're not Illy. My master, tall, skinny, prick with ears. So, you're Shovel's master now. Fine. Master Illy, wonderful. He tricks them, heals them, then they die. So sudden, so mysterious. Shovel comes, Shovel takes them, then we raise them, make them walk. Necromancer, your kind call him. Fun, I call him. Don't know, don't care. Wait, are you horny for the book? Illy never shuts up. Book this, book that. Oh, Master should go see. Talk to the mirror, and remember, balsam, good for burns.
Hey ho.
Oh, shit, piddling toe!
You recognize the time.
Wait! You smell funny. Like fire and iron. So, a fake dragon. Oh, boring. Master Illy is fun. So, you're Shovel's master now. Fine. And you, slab of beef with nipples. Moo! Master Illy calls me Shovel. Don't like it? Change it! So, what first, Master? Gutting locals? Raising the dead? Making them walk? Making them scream? Yes! Steal bodies! Tear them, then Illy puts them back together, again and again. When he wasn't horny for the book. Oh, book this, book that. He loves the book. Oh, Master should go see. Talk to the mirror, and remember, balsam, good for burns. Oh? A spell, Shite. When the fisting starts, use the sparky magic to call Shovel. Let's kill everything.
All right, what now?
Let's get on with it.
Come on, let's go. Attention.
Can't give up now.
Thank you.
You do your best to wipe the dirt from your face and look presentable. Adventuring is murder on one's wardrobe, though.
Speak your name. I do not know this name. If you are known to my master, step forward and declare yourself an ally.
There is a pause as those glass eyes take you in. Then...
I doubt a bear this size went down without a fight.
Assume nothing.
At least things have stayed interesting. I wonder what the next move is. A lock? How tempting.
Book is locked tight with no visible keyhole, only an oval recess in the cover's mouth. You try to examine the book, but the longer you stare, the more those piercing amethyst eyes draw you in.
A cursed book? How obvious. Whoever opens it deserves the fate that befalls them.
Curious. Why don't you take a closer look? I'll observe from back here.
Please don't open the creepy book.
There is work to do.
What to do?
The book is locked tight with no visible keyhole, only an oval recess in the cover's mouth. You try to examine the book, but the longer you stare, the more those piercing amethyst eyes draw you in.
A cursed book? How obvious. Whoever opens it deserves the fate that befalls them.
Curious. Why don't you take a closer look? I'll observe from back here.
Please don't open the creepy book.
Irresistible. You feel changed, bettered for having opened it. Suddenly you are capable of anything. Felling mountains, darkening suns, conversing with the dead. Glyphs shift gently before your eyes. Words slip into your mind, onto your lips, forming words you don't understand. And something is trying to reply. Warping and twisting. Your head throbs, but you almost understand. The world around you is gone. You can only see those glyphs, only hear those voices. You feel claws moving in the shadows. They pull at you, dragging you closer. Glyphs scream, branding your mind with strange runes. You see time rewritten, fate undone, your future thrumming with power. The book snaps closed. You've seen too much. What profane knowledge is now seared inside of you, you should never have known. You've seen much of the book, but its most powerful secrets are guarded by indecipherable glyphs. Without a key, they may be locked away forever.
making me sweat.
Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times.
Stop me yet.
My day just improved. Did you want something? A long way to go still.
Indolence breeds madness. Never a dull moment.
Rested enough. Now, forward.
One of those can summon fighters far and wide.
Look it, Claw! Sapper's here! Unless you've got another reason to be here. Fexite!
As the symbol glows, power courses through you. Authority.
Good for you, mate. Now get out of my sight before my wall grips you a new hole.
This better not be Minfara's messenger. If the boss finds out I gave her a hard time, that's me done.
Lurches, reeling suddenly as if bitten.
Easy, lads. We got a true soul coming through.
Lads are celebrating the raid on Joaquin's Rest. We captured a duke, we did. All the way from the city.
I'm sure the higher-ups will make sure you get the best of the spoils, Your Excellness. The boss is in the temple inside. Minthara, too. And Priestess Gut can show you how many new recruits we got.
Ahead. We'll need a cover storm.
Look it, Claw! Sapper's here! Unless you've got another reason to be here. Fexite!
As the symbol glows, power courses through you. Authority.
Down, Claw! Bad girl!
Your mind lurches, reeling suddenly as if bitten.
Easy, lads. We got a true soul coming through. I don't know any house in Your Excellness.
Oh, one of them thieves. If he ain't dead, he's in the pits with the rest of them.
The pits? He couldn't be somewhere pleasant sounding, could he?
Better still be alive.
Lads are celebrating the raid on Joaquin's Rest. We captured a Duke, we did. All the way from the city.
I'm sure the higher-ups will make sure you get the best of the spoils, Your Excellness. The boss is in the temple inside. Mithara, too. And Priestess Gug can show you how many new recruits we got.
Pardon.
Excuse!
We're gonna miss out on all the drinking!
Shut it!
Your worshipness.
You'd be even less used to be drunk. So shut up! Your eyes peeled.
Not everyone subscribes to... is irresistible. You recognize the overwhelming authority that you've used on others, only infinitely stronger, and turned against you. Your vision clouds, leaving you in a dark, featureless shadowscape. Nothingness in every direction. Then there are three figures before you. An armored male elf, exuding power and command. A handsome younger man with a quick, easy smile. And a pale young woman with even paler eyes.
These are my chosen. They speak for me. Aid their search for the prism, and you will be worthy to stand beside them.
The voice away.
My power grows. My forces gather. The reckoning draws near.
Don't give me that look. I don't know what just happened any more than you do. We should keep going.
The voice is gone. Muted by this Gith relic. Why does a half-elf carry it?
Perhaps. But whatever it was, I don't want to experience it again. I don't know. Not exactly. All I know is it's important I get it back to Baldur's Gate. At any cost. My home. The cloister of Shah followers. Hidden in the city. A group of us were sent to retrieve the artifact. Now I'm the only one left. I can't afford to fail.